don't think what's happening over there is staying over there, well, think again. Hi, everybody. I'm Liz McDonald filling in for David Asman, and welcome to Forbes on Fox. And just this week, two more big American companies warning that things in Europe are dragging down sales. Marriott and Applied Materials joining a list of names quickly piling up. Now, if major American companies are taking a hit from Europe, is America's entire economy next? Let's go in focus with Mike Ozanian, Victoria Barrett, Rick Unger, Mark Tatge, Rich Cargard, and Bill Baldwin. Mike Ozanian, what do you think?
Liz, I think the United States is already in a recession, as are many major European countries, all for the same reason. Too much government debt. It sucked money out of the private sector, which is why businesses aren't expanding, entrepreneurs aren't starting new businesses, and unemployment is very high.
Victoria, what do you think?
Well, I agree with Mike that we've got issues here, but I don't think Europe is going to put us further deeper in the hole immediately. Exports to Europe make up only 2% of America's GDP, not a huge number. The larger risk is financial contagion. If you see U.S. banks start to pull back on lending, that's when we're going to have a real recession. That's when we'll have real big problems.
Yeah,
we're not really seeing that yet.
Rich Cargard, to Victoria's point, I think Canada, then China, then Mexico, Japan, and then Europe matter more to the U.S. economy. What do you think?
Well, you're absolutely right. In raw numbers, they matter a lot more. But you know what? I think that we were so burned by the 2008 meltdown, which many people didn't see, that now we overrate every threat that comes over the horizon. So Victoria's right. I mean, this takes a, you know, a couple tenths of a point off of our potential GDP. We are perilously close to a recession already. That's true. But I don't think this is a big event.
All right, Rick Unger, you know, the CBO, the Federal Reserve, is worried about this so-called fiscal cliff. We do have a capital strike going on in this country where now we've got U.S. treasurers of U.S. companies saying, look, we're parking 50% of our cash in short-term debt and cash in U.S. banks. What do you think is going on there? Isn't that more of a problem?
Yeah, I think we have to be careful. Look, you know, we hear all this bad news going on over there, and it makes us all very nervous. But Victoria did hit this fact right on the nose. She said 2% of our GDP comes from our sales over there. This slowdown, yes, recession, highly unlikely. I will tell you what does worry me. I think that our U.S. banks have far more exposure in the European front than maybe we're being told. This does trouble me because we could see a credit crunch that we could certainly do without.
Bill Baldwin, what do you think?
I think Mike hasn't heard the news yet, but the U.S. housing market bottomed on Tuesday.
Tuesday.
Okay, well, wait a minute now. There's more good news. I think because costs are low in the U.S. relative to abroad, we're bringing manufacturing back on shore. Witness that Chilean plant, which is being dismantled and moved to Louisiana. And there's one more good thing on the horizon. There's a 50-50 chance that we'll repeal Obamacare.
Oh, that's interesting.
Not a chance.
Tatge, here's the deal. I mean, Greece is about the size of Connecticut. Maybe it won't affect the U.S. economy. If our banks have taken the time to shore up their balance sheets, do you think, though, that what matters more is Washington, D.C. policy?
Yes and no. I think that what, you know, who's going to be elected president's going to matter a lot. And what's going to happen with Congress in January in terms of tax situation is a big wild card here. But Europe, I'm not as worried about Europe. I'm more worried about China. I agree with Bill. I think we're out of the woods. I think the economy's slow, but it's actually improving. And I think China is a bigger question. If China goes into the tank or Chinese inflation, that could hurt our economy.
All right, but you
badly.
Know, Michael Zaney, here's the deal. We've got a jobless right now in this decade that's going to beat the bad 1980s in terms of joblessness. And it's effectively, we're going to have to wait to the end of the decade to get our jobless rate below 7% at the rate that we're going. Do you think that's more of an issue? I mean, the issue is that, you know, we've got people in Washington, D.C. that thinks that raising taxes is somehow going to create jobs.
Well, there are three problems, EMAC. Number one is people don't understand how an economy grows. They want to just give consumers money. But that doesn't create jobs because people that run businesses say, oh, the government's dumping more money out, the Fed's printing more money. They're not going to expand businesses because they know that's temporary. What you need is an environment, something bold like Bill Clinton did in 1997, lower the capital gains tax rate. He lowered it by 7 percentage points from Ronald Reagan. That spurred a big boom in the economy and the stock market.
Well, you know, you're out there in California, Victoria. I mean, if tax and spend was the way to go, then wouldn't it have fixed California? I mean, California has an unemployment rate, 12%?
but coming
down. I've said this before. California's unemployment rate should not be where it is, especially considering the growth that I'm seeing right here in Silicon Valley. It makes no sense. And I think it is because we for decades have had this tax and spend boom bust, tax and spend mentality, boom bust reality. You know, I think it's important to look at Europe. And I think Americans are looking at Europe right now and saying, is that our future? Are we going down that path? Maybe not next year, but 5-10 years down the road. That's the significance of Europe to us, and it raises some really important questions.
But, you know, Rick Unger, we've got McDonald's and Kraft's. They're the ones with the big exposure to Europe. And we've, as you pointed out earlier, U.S. banks, we don't really know what their exposure is to Europe. How worried are you?
Well, as I said, I'm a little bit concerned about the banks, but I do want to go back to something you guys were just talking about and repeat what you've heard me say way more times than you would like. If lowering taxes was the answer to jobs, we'd all be all for it. But as we just saw in the figures that came out this week, taxes are at a 30-year low, and sadly, so are jobs.
All right, Carl Gura, take it on.
You know, that's just a false way of looking at it, Rick.
Why?
You know, the taxes might be at a 30-year low, but that's because they're very, very low for half the population that pays no taxes at all. What you should be looking at is taxes on the people who create jobs. And those are the people, Liz used the word capital strike. Capital is on a strike, and that's why small businesses aren't investing in the future and aren't hiring people at the rate they should be.
Bill Baldwin, is this why, you know, companies in the U.S. are basically afraid of what's happening here in Washington, D.C., and they've seen the experience in Europe and what's going on in Europe?
I think what they see in Europe is not a loss of sales so much as a dismal end to the U.S. if we go down the Greek path.
Exactly.
So it's very useful. What Victoria said was right on target. This is actually salutary if we take a lesson from it. We can see what happens to a welfare state when it goes off a cliff.
All right. But, you know, Mark Tatge, our U.S. economy is restructuring. I think that's what gets lost in all the media coverage of what's going on in Europe. We've got a great apps economy where Rich and Victoria out there in California. We've got health services, infotech services, even legal services, even though some would say too many lawyers. But aren't we diversifying, restructuring time and again? Is this being missed out there in the media?
I think I agree with that exactly, Emac. You know, we're going through this change. It's been a very painful change. We're going through where I'm at here in the Midwest, where you don't see that, where we're moving away from a manufacturing. Yes, we're a service economy, but there's new types of manufacturing, green manufacturing coming in. There's small businesses are actually growing and prospering, but we're not hearing about that.
And Rich
we're
Carlgard,
just not hearing about
you
that.
Know, to Mark Tatge's point, also nat gas is a big booming industry thanks to Gerald Ford and Jimmy Carter. What do you think of that?
Yeah, it is. And of course, you know, Pennsylvania and Ohio and states like that are really benefiting from that. But I want to point out on Mark Tatge, Indiana is doing well. And you know why? Because they have a really fiscally prudent governor, Mitch Daniels.
Oh, he's the reason.
They're doing well in some areas, not all.
All right. We have to leave it there, guys. Always hilarious. Next.